Great morning, dear students. So today we will be continuing with our lesson Father's Help. In the previous class we discussed about the author R.K. Narayan and his work and his life, and also discussed about the different characters involved in this story. Which are the characters? Swami and his mother, father and his teacher Samuel. These are the important characters. Now let us start reading. Okay, let us see what is mentioned in the first page of the lesson. See, Swami, he was lying in the bed and suddenly he woke up with a shudder, that it was a great shock and fear, and then he realized it is a Monday morning. So why was he is in a great shock? Because he realized that he has to go to the school Monday morning. Saturday, Sunday, holiday over, weekend over, now it's time to go to the school. So he was not willing to go to the school, and he says here that has been last period on Friday. That means he says here that it's just a moment ago that I finished with my last period on Friday, and Monday also came so quickly. So what he says next, that what he wishes, already Monday was here. And next what he wishes for an earthquake to take place. Okay, now as we have already, like we all may have at some or the other point of time, we have made such silly prayers or wishes that if we don't want to go somewhere, if we don't want to do certain things, then we start praying, this should happen so that I don't have to do these things. Or this should be like, if you don't want to come to the school, you may pray sometimes it should rain very heavily, or some emergency kind of situation should be declared, emergency holidays, so though we don't have to attend the school. So in the same way, what Swami is praying here, he is hoping for an earthquake to take place and reduce his school, the building, which is the Albert Mission School. What is the name of his school? Albert Mission School should reduce to the earth. That means it should, like, the building should be completely collapsed and he doesn't have to attend the school. What he says next here, similar prayers were made by many of the students. Okay, so such prayers have been made by every day by some of the other students, but the building is still there, standing strong from 100 years. Okay, over 100 years now. Now what do we read next? That at 9 o'clock Swaminathan wailed. Wailed here means cried. What did he say? When we are in pain, then we take, make a painful noise and we say something about the belief or the trouble. That is, I have a headache. What is the problem he is having? I have a headache. So now you can just imagine yourself in the same place when you don't want to attend the school. What are you going to do? You pretend. Okay. Here also he has a pretext, a lie, a false impression to give to his mother and father that he is having an headache and should be excused for going to the school. So what did the mother reply? Mother said, why don't you go to the school in Jutka? What is Jutka? You will read here, Jutka is a like two-wheeled horse-drawn cart. Okay, so instead of walking and going, you go and take a Jutka horse-drawn carriage and it will be easy for you to reach the school. But Swami was well prepared for everything, mentally prepared. And Voxy says that if I go with the Jutka, then I will be completely dead. Completely dead in the sense that it is going to jolt me so much, it is going to move here and there and throw me here and there. As we all know that it gives a lot of jerk when we are on the horse cart. That is going to increase my headache immensely. So that is what he says, that it's not a good idea to go into the Jutka. Next, his mother asks, any important lesson? Do you have an important lesson? What he says? Important. Geography teacher is teaching the same lesson for a year now. So I don't have any important lesson. Okay, because the teacher is repeating the same thing again and again from a year now. That means he wants to say that continuously she has been teaching the same thing. Then half arithmetic whole period and we have a arithmetic period, and what is going to happen, whole period teacher is going to beat us very badly because it's very difficult subject to understand and to explain the things to the teacher also, whatever she asks them. He says, I don't have any important lesson today. So that's what we want to convey to his mother, to convince her. So, and mother, generously means very warmly, kindly, she says that it's okay, you don't attend the school today. Oh, may stay at home. You might stay at home. Okay. Now see, the next. This is over with his mother. What do we see next at 9:30 p.m. 9:30. Okay. When he ought to have been shouting, what is usually he is doing at 9:30? He is in his school and chanting the prayers. Okay. What is he doing now? But today he is lying on the bench in his mother's room. And then suddenly who comes there? Father. Swami's father. And then what he asks is such an obvious question. He's going to ask, have you no school today? Okay, are you not going to your school today? So what would be the reply of Swami? As usual, he says that I have a headache. And mother, she very easily, quickly, she got convinced. It was very easy to convince his mother. But fathers, as I told you, it is not very easy for us to convince our father. Okay, so he says here, obviously you are going to have headache. Why? Because you keep on roaming the whole weekend, Saturdays and Sundays. You loaf about. Okay, see, loaf about less on Sunday. That means you stop wasting your time on Sundays going here and there, and then automatically you will have no headache on Monday. But you're doing so many crazy things and going out and spending your time idly. So that is why you're having headache on Monday. So Swami, now here he knew that his father was very stubborn. Stubborn here means he was very determined. Whatever he has decided, it is very difficult to change his mind and his attitude. Okay. So what he says here, that now Swami tries to change his tactics. Tactics here means the strategy what he has made. What he did next, what he says, I can't go so late to the class. What he says next now he has shifted his point from headache to the going late to the class, that I can't go because why? Teacher is going to punish me. So his father says, that's your own fault. Okay, if you have done something wrong, you should be ready to bear the consequences. Okay, so he says, it's your own fault, I agree, but you have to go to the school. Okay, then Swami asks him, his father, what will I say to teacher if I go so late? What is she going to think about me? Okay, so he says that you can tell your teacher you have a headache. What is the next thing that Swami comes up with? He says, you will beat me. The teacher is going to beat me. Now, next his father says, we will see. Oh, if you go late to the school, he is going to beat you. What is his name? Who is the teacher that he is going to beat you if you go late to the school? Okay. So what names he takes? He takes the name of his teacher, Samuel. Okay. He says, now what, his father is getting very curious. Okay. To know about more of his teacher, Samuel. Does he beat the boys? So he asks, is he beating the boys regularly so much? He is very violent. Very violent here means very dangerous. Okay. With the boys who come late, especially with the boys who come late. And what he does, he made to sit on their knees, on his knees, and then for the whole period in the corner of the class. And then he says, sometimes he also gives canes. Okay, 6 cuts from the cane. What is cane? As I told you in the previous class, it is a hollow stem of a grass used to beat on the palm of the student. Earlier it was used. Okay, so he says that not only he will punish me or the boys to sit in the corner on their knees in the class, but also he is going to give us the cane. Okay, 6 canes. Until and unless he sees the blood on the palm, he is going to beat us. And he is always twisting our ears. I wouldn't like to go late. And he says that he is so dangerous, I cannot go to his class late. Okay, so his father is now getting interested in this, and he's like, how can a teacher be so cruel? Okay, how can he beat a child so much that the blood comes out? So he says, is he so violent? So tell your headmaster about, why did not you complain about the teacher to your headmaster if he is troubling you all so much, if he beats you so much? Then what is the reply of Swami? Even the headmaster is scared of him. So Swami, here you can see that how good he is at making up the stories. Now the story is written by R.K. Narayan. Inside that there is one more story which was being described or being made up by Swami himself. Okay, so he says even the headmaster is afraid of him. He is not going to say anything in front of him. Now let's read the third page. What is there in this page? See, and then Swami gave a lurid account of Sami. What is lurid? Lurid here means unpleasant, not very good. Okay, giving the bad impression of his teacher in front of his father, that he is very dangerous. What all things he does? What he does, he says, then he starts screaming, and he would not stop until he sees the blood on the hands of the boy or the children. And then what he does next, after caning, getting the blood out from the hand, and then he asks them to press on the forehead of the students like a vermilion. Okay, vermilion means the tika which we put, okay, that thing. Or sometimes he will ask the boys to smear the blood on his face. Smear means to like apply the blood on the face. So such is the like the impression, the explanation that he is presenting in front of his father about his teacher Sami. Okay, now what he expected when he is saying all these things, he would have expected a father will tell him that, okay, this is so dangerous that you don't go to the school, you stay back here, or I don't want my child to be beaten. But it was a unexpected behavior of the father which Swami saw. Okay, he never expect what is going to happen. Now his father got very excited in the sense that let us face and teach a lesson to such kind of teacher. Okay, now when he says an unexpected turn, excited, for teachers mean by beating and must be driven out of the service. Now what he says next year, if such is the case, if these are the teachers of your school, they should be thrown out of the school. I'll make a complaint against that teacher, and you give the letter to the headmaster, and then we will both together teach him a lesson. Okay, now see, result was that he proposed send Swami late. Now he is purposely sending Swami late to the class just to see what is the teacher going to do. Okay, the father sends Swami late to the class to see what reaction the teacher gives, the teacher Samuel gives, and he took it as a challenge. Okay, now no amount of protest. Now even if Swami makes any kind of excuse, the gentleman also, he has to go now, because his father has made up the mind to teach the lesson to the teacher Samuel and see what is going to happen. So away. So no protest was of any avail. Avail here means help. Swami had to go to the school. So no other choice he had now. So by the time Swami gets ready, father composed a letter and sealed it. Put it in the envelope and sealed. Letter is what? Letter of complaint against the teacher Samuel, which he asked Swaminathan to give it to the headmaster. Okay, now when he was handed over the letter, Swami, he asked, have you written about Samuel? So what is inside the letter? Have you written anything against Samuel? So what his father's reply? Your headmaster will be reading it. You don't need to worry. Okay, probably dismiss Samuel. And after reading the letter, he may probably means there are chances that he is going to Samuel throw out of the school and hand him over to the police. Not only he is going to throw him out of the school, but he is also going to hand him over to the police. Okay, so what has he done, father? Now he is being very genuinely asking, like an innocent person, innocent child, that Samuel has done anything. He has himself given account of Samuel so much, and now he himself is asking what Samuel has done now. Well, there is a full account of everything he has done in the letter. Give it to your headmaster. You must bring an acknowledgement. Now he says that you don't have to only deliver the letter, but also you have to bring an acknowledgement. What is an acknowledgement? That you should like bring something in the proof that your principal, the headmaster, has taken the note of the complaint. Okay, acceptance of the letter, and in the evening I am going to see him. So this is what we are going to read till here, and we are going to continue with this in the next class.